Hey there, Sam here from ByteByteByte.com, and today I want to talk about how to be confident in your interview. So I'm going to show you exactly how you can go into your interview, make a great first impression, be confident, and I'm going to give you a specific exercise that you can start applying today to make that happen. All right, so today I want to talk about how to be confident in your interview. And this is such an important topic because confidence is really the foundation of your actual interview success. Right? A lot of times we think about, oh, the most important thing in our interview is, you know, having the technical skills and making sure that we have solved tons and tons of practice problems. And while that's super important, the fact of the matter is that if you're not confident and if you're not self-assured and if you're really nervous going into your interview, the rest of that doesn't matter. Right, like I'm sure we've all had this experience where we go into the interview and we're really, really nervous and we're stressing out about the interview and we've had our mind go completely blank. It's like they asked us a super easy question. It wasn't something that we thought we were going to struggle with. And then all of a sudden, everything just like vanishes from our mind. And then as soon as you walk out of the interview, it's like it hits you, right? You remember and you know exactly how to solve it. As soon as you're out of the interview, as soon as it was too late for you to actually do anything about it. And that's such a frustrating thing because it means that as long as you have those nerves and as long as you're unable to be confident in your interview, it's really, really hard for you to be successful. And so today I want to talk about a strategy that you can use, and I also want to talk a bit about the psychology of being confident in your interview. So let's start with the psychology. And I want you to imagine for a second, how would you physically act if you were happy? How would you physically act if you were sad? How would you physically act if you were angry? And tell me, would that be different in those different situations? I think we all realize that like when we're happy, we act a certain way. When we're sad, we act a different way. The way we walk, the way we hold our body changes. And that's something that we're all pretty aware of, right? Our psychology, the way that we're thinking, affects our physiology, which is the way that we're actually holding ourselves. And so that's, you know, fairly common knowledge, but the difference and the other thing that we have to realize is that not only does our psychology affect our physiology, but our physiology can actually affect our psychology. And this is what we're going to dig into today, because this is such an important point to realize, is that even if we don't feel confident and even if we don't feel a certain way, by acting a certain way and by, you know, holding our body in a certain way, it can actually change the way that we're thinking. And so I want to actually give you an example of an exercise that you can try right now, and it will show you how this works. And this is a weird one, but I guarantee that if you try this, you're going to be surprised by the results of this. And so what you got to do is as soon as this video ends, after you give us a like and you subscribe to the channel, as soon as this video ends, close the door and force yourself to laugh. This is the way that it works. You sit down, you set a timer on your phone for 1 minute and force yourself to laugh for 1 minute. And you're gonna look like a crazy person. You don't wanna, you know, you wanna make sure that the doors are closed and no one's walking in on you because they're gonna think you're, you know, absolutely nuts doing this. But when you do that, what you're gonna realize is that at first it's super awkward. At first you feel really uncomfortable forcing yourself to laugh because there's nothing funny. And it's not something that you want to be doing necessarily. But what you'll realize is that as the minute progresses, as you get to the end of the minute, all of a sudden, it becomes hard to stop laughing. And you realize, you're like, I don't know what's funny. I don't know why this is funny, but it is. And I just can't stop laughing. And it's such a weird feeling. But what you'll realize by doing that is that by forcing yourself to laugh, by affecting your physiology, you are having an impact on your psychology. And that's what I want you to think about when you're preparing for your interviews and when you're going into your interview. And so the basic strategy here that I would encourage you to apply in your interviews is to essentially just act like you're not nervous, right? I know this sounds easier to say than it probably is in practice, but the fact of the matter is that if you can control the way that you're acting and the way that you're behaving, then that's going to affect how you feel. And I do want to give you a specific exercise that you can try today and that you can start applying that's going to work for affecting your physiology and affecting your psychology as you're going into the interviews in the future. And so this strategy I call the doorway technique. And the way that the doorway technique works is very, very simple. With the doorway technique, all you do is every time you walk through a doorway, whether it's for your interview or anything else, every time you walk through a doorway, you stand up tall and you smile. And you just do it every time you walk through the doorway. And what you're going to realize by doing that is two things. One, the standing up tall and smiling is a very, very simple thing that you can do to improve your confidence and improve sort of your demeanor, right? So it's going to affect the way in which you are, it's going to affect the way in which you are sort of presenting yourself to the world, and it's going to make you seem confident and self-assured. But also, the doorway acts as a trigger. And so it takes a little practice at the beginning to get used to it, but what you'll realize as you keep doing this and you do it over and over is that every time you go through a doorway when you do this, now all of a sudden it becomes natural. And this is what you want to be thinking about when you're preparing for your interviews, is how do I make these things as natural as possible? You don't want to be trying to figure out, like, you know, thinking about, oh, I need to smile and I need to do this and I need to do that when you're actually going into your interview, because it's going to be distracting, right? If you're giving a presentation, you don't want to be doing something for the first time and trying it for the first time while you're also trying to do a million other things. And so the doorway technique allows you to develop this habit. And the great thing about doorways, and the reason why I love the doorway specifically as a trigger, is that what happens every time you walk through a doorway? Well, every time you walk through a door, you're interacting with new people. Every time you go into an interview, you're walking through the doorway into the room. Every time you walk through a doorway, you're coming into a new room where there are potentially new people. And so if you want to make a good first impression, the doorway is the perfect trigger to make you reset your physiology when it's most important. And so that's why this is an awesome technique to try. I would highly encourage you to try this as well, because it's going to help you to affect your physiology, which will then help you affect your psychology. And so that's all I got for you today. If you enjoyed this video, please hit the subscribe button below. And we also have our free 50 interview questions guide, which I would encourage you to check out, where we have solutions to the top 50 interview questions that companies ask. And I look forward to seeing you all in the next video.